the marbles. The Aggie Eagle Classic, as they call it, versus North Carolina Central. The winner of this game wins the first outright MEAC championship since 2012. They also punched their ticket to the Air Force Reserve Celebration Bowl, which will be played right here in Atlanta December 17th at the Georgia Dome. And Coach, when you look at this North Carolina Central team that Coach Jerry Mack has been able to assemble, what are some of the things that concern you headed into this matchup?
The quarterback, you know, I think he's the key to the operation, and he's an outstanding player and does a really good job. I think their offensive line is outstanding and do a good job. They're a very well-coached football team, and they play hard, and you can see why they're one of the top teams in this league is because they're well-coached, play hard, and have good players.
You know, it seems a little different this year, and different than previous years, because you've had, you know, the same teams pretty much competing for, or not just competing, but actually winning a portion of the MEAC championship between you guys up there in North Carolina A&T. Then you got North Carolina Central, South Carolina State, and also Bethune-Cookman. And I can't forget Morgan State actually slid in there here recently. But this year, you know, Bethune is having a down year. South Carolina State is having a down year. And you and North Carolina Central find yourselves undefeated in MEAC play. But with that being said, what are your thoughts? Because I know that the MEAC is a very tough conference, but what are your thoughts on the competitiveness of the MEAC this year?
Well, you know, it's a great league and, you know, great competition in this league. And you know, a lot of teams only mistake away from being in this thing again. And, you know, that's usually the difference between winning and losing sometimes, a mistake. You know, in all fairness, you know, we had a chance to win outright the last 2 years, but couldn't get the job done because Century ended up beating us.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully this year we can go and play better than we played in the past and, you know, represent a little bit better.
So the fact that your guys have not been able to defeat North Carolina Central the past two seasons, what do you attribute that to? Is that just like the luck of the draw, so to speak? Because this is a rivalry game, and we know a lot of times you could throw the records out the window because it's all about pride and bragging rights. So you think that this is the case with the matchup between North Carolina Central and A&T?
I think most rivalries are like that. If you look and you watch North Carolina and Duke play last week, you watch, you know, the Oklahoma, the Texas play, you know, usually, you know, it's a mistake here or there. It's a difference in the ball game. And obviously we made a few more than they've made in the last couple of years. So, you know, hopefully we can play a little bit better this year.
Now, before I let you go, last week we previewed the CIAA football championship right here on the show. And we had Coach Keanis Bulwer from Winston-Salem State and also Damon Wilson from Bowie State on the show. And they were, you know, I talked to them, you know, about the CIAA championship being the final game unless you, you know, made it into the playoffs. And both coaches were under, you know, they both thought that it might be a good idea to have a four-team HBCU style playoff, you know, like they do at the FBS level, but include, you know, MEAC, SWAC, SIAC, CIAA, and you know, Winston-Salem State, they were like, yeah, we love to get on the field with North Carolina A&T, and I was like, no, you don't, and they were like, yes, we do. So, you know, what are your thoughts on something like that possibly happening? Is that something that you would be interested in seeing?
Well, you know, my preference, personal preference right now is there's more value in playing people like, you know, Kent State, mm-hmm. University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, you know, Duke, East Carolina. You know, I want my guys to have the experience of doing that.
They're playing the best.
You know, and, they're playing, you know, the top-level teams. And, you know, Winston had a chance to be in this thing. They decided to go back. So,
right.
You know, to be
right.
one double A, that's their decision, you know. So, but we're happy where we are. And, you know, again, it sounds, you know, like it may have some merit to it, but my preference is for my team is to, you know, play the North Carolina, the Dukes, the East Carolina teams like that, the Tulsas, the Kent States, Division I programs, because I think that makes you better.
Absolutely, and actually gets you ready for that conference competition. Makes that conference mm-hmm. competition, yeah, absolutely. All right, so it goes down today, 2 o'clock kickoff from North Carolina Central's O'Kelly Riddick Stadium. It is the Aggie Eagle Classic 2016, and it is for all the marbles. The MEAC Championship, the first outright championship since 2012, will be decided today. A representative from the MEAC for this year's Celebration Bowl will be crowned today. All right. And he is Coach Rod Broadway. Coach, thank you so much for joining us on the show. And we wish you nothing but the best of luck today. And we know if you win today, we'll see you in a couple weeks.
Brother, thank you. In the meantime, just give me a jingle.
All right. Thanks, man. All right. Great stuff right there from Rod Broadway. Arguably the brightest mind ever in HBCU football. I'm just saying, man, we all love Coach Rob. But Coach Rob didn't win three championships at three different universities. I'm just saying. You know, sometimes you have to carve out your own niche. And that's what Coach Broadway's done. So big shouts out to him. All right, so coming up on the other side, as we continue talking Aggie Eagles Classic 2016, Jerry Mack, the head football coach of the North Carolina Central University Eagles, joins us when we return. This is the HBCU Report, and I am Rod Calloway.
The HBCU experience lives here. The HBCU Report with Rob Calloway. We'll be right back.
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Jason Derulo. I love that music connects to people all over the country. But unfortunately, so does something else. Childhood hunger. 15 million kids struggle with hunger right here in America. And yet, every year, billions of pounds of surplus food in the U.S. go to waste instead of going to the children in need. Feeding America is working to change this. The Feeding America Nationwide Network of Food Banks rescues this surplus of food to help provide meals to families in virtually every community in the United States, including yours. But they just can't do this alone. Join me in the fight against hunger in America. For more information on what you can do to get involved, visit feedingamerica.org. That's feedingamerica.org. Together we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America. A message from Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Connecting the SWAC, the MEAC, SIAC, and the CIAA, the HBCU experience lives here. It's the HBCU Report with Bob Calloway.
Young Metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot.
Beautiful morning, yeah, the sun in my morning, babe. Nothing
in the water. Man, I love that song. Man, I don't know how many of you all actually heard the Kanye West album. Oh, man. That Pablo album. Oh, that's my joint. Yeah. This is the HBCU Report being heard via Spreaker.com. Don't forget, you can also hear the show via iTunes, Google Play, Android, and the TuneIn Radio app. So multiple ways to actually hear the show, download the show. Make sure that you do that. We're getting close to around 1,000 downloads for the season. So this is week 12. So we're getting close to 1,000. So I'm hoping that between this week and next week, because you know what I haven't mentioned is that I think we're going to do two shows next week because we have the Turkey Day Classic coming up next Thursday. And then we have the Bayou Classic coming up next Saturday. So I think there's going to be a special edition of the HBCU Report coming up during the week. So just keep your fingers crossed. Yeah, please. And I will keep you posted. That's what I'm hoping to do. I really want to be able to do this show more than just once a week. But we'll see how that works out. All right. But getting back to the big game today. Well, yeah, you didn't hear? Yeah, it's a big time matchup today. And it's not being played in Florida. It's being played in North Carolina at O'Kelly Riddick Stadium on the campus of North Carolina Central. It is the Aggie Eagle Classic, the 2016 edition. And this one is for all the marbles. The winner of this game not only wins the first outright MEAC championship since 2012, but they also punched their ticket to the 2016 Air Force Reserve Celebration Bowl, which goes down December 17th, right here at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. And so we are being joined right now on the line by the head football coach of the North Carolina Central Eagles. He is Jerry Mack. First of all, Coach, I know it seems like yesterday you were on the show, but welcome back.
No problem. Thank you guys for having me.
Not a problem, man. So the last time we had you on the show, which was just a few weeks ago, you all were getting ready for a matchup against Morgan State. It was actually their homecoming when we had you on. And, you know, things have just continued to get better and better for the Eagles since we last spoke. You guys still undefeated in the MEAC heading into this matchup against North Carolina A&T. So, since we last spoke to you, have there been any surprises along the way? You know, where you like, wow, I can't believe we're still undefeated in this thing.
I don't think it was surprising more than anything. I think we were right there where we wanted our goals to be. We talked about having the opportunity to control our own destiny this year. Like you said, this is the first year in probably about 3 or 4 years, had a chance to play for our outright championship. So, you know, our team goals are right where we wanted them right now. So it was still in the same situation. We control our own destiny to try to go to a Celebration Bowl. The kids have done a great job of making sure they stay focused. You know, it's tough because, you know, probably after that Morgan State game, you can kind of start looking ahead some, but our kids stayed focused and they just took it one game at a time to put themselves in this position this week.
Now, I spoke to Coach Broadway, and, you know, I'm always talking to this dude, and I'm always trying to explain him, like, Coach, you know, outside of your little bubble, like, dude, you're a living legend. Like, dude, you won the SWAC. You won a HBCU championship at Grambling. You've done the same thing at North Carolina Central. You've done it at A&T. So, you know, what's your thoughts on coaching up against a guy with the resume of a Rod Broadway?
A lot of respect for Coach Broadway, what he's done in his profession, and especially at this level with all the obstacles sometimes at HBCUs, he's been able to sustain winning and do it at a high level at a numerous number of places. And, you know, a guy that's, you know, still young in the profession like myself, you see a guy that's done this deal for, you know, almost 30 years, you know, just got tremendous respect for what he's been able to accomplish as a football coach.
No doubt about it. This is the HBCU Report. Rob Calloway talking Aggie's Eagle Classic. It goes down on the campus of North Carolina Central today. For all the marbles, an outright MEAC championship is at stake. Jerry Mack, head football coach of the North Carolina Central University Eagles, on the line with us right now. So, Coach, from a health perspective, how are you guys right now?
We're feeling good. You know, we're pretty healthy. We were fortunate this year. We had probably maybe only one or two season-ending injuries to some guys that contributed. But for the most part, I mean, we're good to go. No different than the normal bumps and bruises during this time of the year. You know, tell the guys all the time, it's football. If you think your body's going to be 100% the entire year, and you're sadly mistaken. So for the most part, you know, we're right where we need to be, healthy enough going into this game.
Now, you know, the one thing that Coach Broadway spoke on when we spoke a few minutes ago was the fact that, you know, the reason that there has not been an outright MEAC champion is because North Carolina Central has knocked A&T off the last 2 years in this game. So what's going to have to happen in order for your guys to knock off a very talented A&T Aggies team?
One thing about A&T, they don't hurt themselves a lot. They don't have a lot of penalties. They don't have a lot of turnovers. And I think that's what we got to make sure that it happens for us in order to have a chance to win the game. We can't turn the ball over and have dumb penalties. So we can't go out there and make a lot of mistakes, so to speak. And then the second thing is, I think the hidden battles in the trenches. I think those guys are very good up front. Those guys' defensive line and their offensive line as well. I think they got one of the best core units in the entire MEAC. So, you know, we got to do a great job of trying to control the line of scrimmage. So whoever controls the line of scrimmage, you can minimize the mistakes and penalties. That's who's going to have a chance to win the game at the end.
Absolutely. Wrapping up with Jerry Mack, head football coach of the North Carolina Central University Eagles. They host North Carolina A&T this weekend. Big time matchup, man. MEAC championship at stake. Now, Coach, before I let you go, know you celebrated a birthday a couple days after that Morgan State game. What'd you do for your birthday?
I didn't do anything.
What?
Yeah, I just tried to get ready, get prepared for the next game. You know, that's the difficult part about having my birthday in season, that you don't get a whole lot of downtime to celebrate. You get about maybe a couple of hours, maybe a couple of people sing happy birthday to you, and then you got to go on to the next day.
Oh, that sucks, man. Well, guess what? Y'all win this thing right here. It's going to be a happy birthday. It's going to be a celebration like none other, because you'll be headed to the Celebration Bowl. So
I think you're definitely right.
Oh, yeah, this will be the greatest birthday present of all. And then you get to do it in the ATL. Well, it's a lot of celebrating going on in the A, man, if you haven't heard.
I definitely heard.
All right, he is Jerry Mack, head football coach, North Carolina Central University Eagles. Coach, thank you so much for joining us on the show, and good luck versus A&T.
No problem. Thank you.
All right, I think we're going to have us a good one today, man. The Aggie Eagle Classic.